And here we will discuss about continuous random variable. And continuous random variable is really abundant in around you. We know till now we discuss about four mainly discrete random variable. And discrete random variable, that one is having very simple kind of mathematics. Easily we can visualize, easily we can compute, manipulate, and everything we can do. But when you are talking about continuous random variable, things would be a little bit complicated, but no worry. Why? Because we are having idea of calculus. Calculus is going to solve all those difficulties that one is associated with continuous random variable. So coming to outline of today's lecture, first I would like to discuss about what is continuous random variable. So we had already seen that discrete random variable, so it is totally depends upon the definition of a random variable and the associated range of the random variable. So generally random variable, we define it from sample space to R, and we focus on range of the this map. Okay, if range of this map, random variable as a map, or what we call it, function. So if we had already characterized, if range, that we denoted by omega x, if it is a discrete set, then that leads to define discrete random variable. If it is a discrete set, then it says that the corresponding random variable would be a discrete random variable. Okay, so that we had already seen several things about discrete random variable. Today we will talk about the continuous nature of the range of a random variable. So it simply implies that the corresponding random variable is a discrete random variable. That means x is a discrete random variable. X, in short, I will write it d dot r dot v dot. Okay, if range happens to be a discrete random variable, but if range of the this random variable, it happens to be a continuous set, that means non-discrete set, then a continuous set, then simply a union of continuous set, then what is happening, that in that case the random variable, we will call it continuous random variable. Okay, continuous set, then in that case the corresponding random variable, we will call it a continuous random variable. So that is the simple definition of what we call it, random variable, continuous random variable. Okay, afterward we will discuss further about probability of an event and examples on various things that generally we will talk about probability of event. So event, we will talk from the perspective of infinity here. Infinity will come, that that means a random variable x, it is taking value in continuous fashion, then we see that we will define event like x is observing value up to x. It is not equality concept will come here, like in discrete random variable we had seen that an event is defined by random variable is that x equal to x is observing particular value. But here in the case of continuous random variable, we will define an event by equality. Okay, this kind of situation would be here in case of continuous random variable. So coming to definition part of the continuous random variable, and what is continuous random variable? So discrete random variable, generally we had already seen that it takes value either it is taking finite value or countably infinite number of value. That means simply I would like to say that range of discrete random variable happens to be either a finite set, that omega s, it is a finite set, or it would be equal to a finite set, or it would be equal to set of natural number or set of integers, or it may be set of natural number or subset of natural number also you can call it. So that's why finite set is covering all those, or it may be integers. So such scenario is coming with respect to discrete random variable. But if you are having a random variable which is taking a value uncountably infinite value, simply I would like to say that uncountably infinite, that means if range of the random variable is uncountably infinite, but that means that one is not possible to introduce bijection from natural number, from omega x to natural number. So in that case, the range of x would be uncountably infinite. That means this one, simply we say that range of the random variable is uncountable, means it is not a discrete set, it is a non-discrete set, that means it is a continuous set. Uncountably infinite, simply it is a continuous set. That what is situation that it, but that means it includes either interval or union of interval. That situation is coming there. Okay. So as the random variables here, continuous random variable, it take value in continuum. Okay, here continuous random variable is taking value in continuum. What is meaning of continuum? That means the random variable, continuous random variable is taking value either from an interval or union of intervals. So this situation, this one is very much important, that when you are defining continuous random variable, you will always see that the possible value of x, that x is observing, it is always from either interval or union of interval. So probability is computed how? Probability is computed as an area under a curve, that area between a curve and the x-axis, that also we can say that. So here probability is just equivalent to computing area wise, and area would be under a certain curve. So that curve we will call it probability density function. The situation is coming like this way, that means the here you can say that along horizontal axis we are taking x as a random variable is observing value along the horizontal axis and the corresponding vertical axis. What is happening, that what is the density of x? That means x may be very dense. X as x is a what? It is a continuous random variable, so x will take value in continuum fashion. So two situations would be there, that x value of x would be very dense or maybe very rare. So such situation, or maybe moderate. There are various situation, possible situation. Like someone is taking that x is value, taking value like this way, very dense, like this. Like this situation is coming. So here we say that x is taking value. Value observing. If you are taking value from the interval a to b or from the this interval to this interval, then you can observe that here. Here the value of x is very near to each other, very near to each other, so that way density is very high. That's why the plot, the curve is talking about density of the observed value of x. The value of x, whether it is dense or rare, it is just described by a curve, this curve. And if you are taking area of that curve under between certain point of x, then that would talk about probability that x is falling between these two points. Okay, so here this curve is very much important. We will call it density or probability density function. It is different from probability mass function. So there is no concept of directly defining probability mass function for continuous random variable. We have to come up with a new kind of distribution function, that we are calling it probability density function. Okay. So, for example, if you are talking about example of continuous random variable, then if you just measure or observe height of various people, then what is happening, that height will vary from, height will take value from the interval. Like Indian people generally, they are having height between what 150 centimeter to 180 or 190, you can go like that way. So that means there is a complete interval, you can say that. Even you can take height below as well, 140 centimeter to 170 or 180, you can go up to like this way. So it is like that, what height is always observing value between from what interval. It is height is taking possible value from interval. Likewise weight, if you talk about weight also varies from 40 or 30 kg to 90 or 100 kg, something like that. So weight is also taking value from the interval. So height, weight, all these are what? These are continuous random variable. If you try to observe, measure this value, okay. So weight would vary from 30 kg to 150 or something like that. You can go as per observe value, okay. As per 100 kg or something, even more than 100 kg, you can go like that. If you try to measure the temperature, the temperature is also varying continuously. if you talk about RAN, quantity of RAN, that means this millimeter of RAN or that millimeter of RAN in particular area, that also vary in a continuous fashion. So there are various example of continuous RAN variable in practical. Okay, so if you take any concept of this, so what is it? Once we are having idea of continuous RAN variable, then we have to come up to characterize or describe continuous RAN variable in detail. So we had already seen various concept regarding discrete RAN variable. So what is the easy way to discuss important concept regarding continuous RAN variable? It is like that, whatever concept you discuss for discrete RAN variable, then in order to generalize it for continuous RAN variable, here there in the case of discrete RAN variable, like defining expectation of variance, you had seen summing the weighted sum, okay, sum of weighted value of random variable. Okay, so replace those sum by integral in case of describing continuous random variable, and the distribution function of discrete random variable, that generally we call it probability mass function, we need to replace it by corresponding characterization of distribution of continuous random variable, that we are calling it PDF. Okay, so we have to replace probability mass function by probability density function. That is the change. That if you want to introduce any concept for continuous random variable, what you do, you replace this sum by integral and the probability mass function by probability density function. So that is the thing, that replacement will talk about various concept of continuous random variable in order to characterize that. Okay, so coming to most important part of a continuous random variable, that one is characterization of the pattern of the observed value of x. That means how x is observing value in continuum fashion, whether it is dense or what is the dense. Simply we will talk about dense, like if you are talking about a solid body, then what is happening, that we always come up with definition of density. What is the density of solid body? So solidity of a solid body, it is always characterized by density. Why? Because in mass we can see that density is very much conserved together, or fixed. They are very much near to each other, very much dense. So that's why density is very much essential to define mass. So similar concept is coming here, like in the case of continuous random variable. So the distribution pattern of a continuous random variable is always characterized by a probability density function. So what is probability density function? It is defined from, again we can say that from range of the random variable, continuous random variable omega x to r. So it is different from probability, but if this probability density function, it is characterizing the pattern, distribution pattern of the continuous random variable, but it is not probability. What is it? It is actually probability per unit area. So probability per unit area, that means how we define it, that means if you take random variable here, we know that it is taking value from the continuum fashion, so we can't take one specific value of x. So generally always in case of continuous random variable, we will say that x is taking value from an interval. So interval, that interval may be as small as possible or as big as possible. So simply call it the concept of interval. So suppose x is observing value here between x and x plus delta, that means there is an interval of length delta, very small interval of length delta. So then if we are having such kind of situation that x is observing value between x and x plus delta, then how we can introduce density function? So easily we can introduce probability. So okay, so density is what? So density is the, again I told that it is probability per unit area. So how we will define it? That means take, so probability, that how we define probability, that x is observing value between x to x plus delta. So this quantity is talking about probability that x is observing value between x and x plus delta. Less than equal to is not going to affect. You can take here less than equal to and less than, both would have the same probability. Okay, there would be no any problem here because of continuum fashion. Okay, so per probability per unit area, how we define it? We take probability that x is observing value between x and x plus delta, and we are dividing by the corresponding unit. Okay, corresponding length. So this quantity is talking about probability per unit area, and we know that here If we take limiting case of this one, that means when we are taking lambda is approaching to zero, then this protobar area will converge to a function. That function we are calling a probability density function. So this is the definition of probability density function. If you try to see, so, and what is happening, that if you talk about approximation, that means approximation of this limit in the small neighborhood of x, that means delta might be as small as possible. So in that case, we can say that how we can define probability that x is taking value between x plus x to x plus delta, it is just approximately equal to the value of density at that point multiplied by a small that width of the interval. So it is just talking about approximation. So approximation, it is very much easily clear from this picture. You can see like this way. So if you are having a random variable x and you are coming with density of that density, how the random variable x is observing value, so in that process you will get this is the density of the corresponding random variable. And here if you are willing to calculate probability that x is observing value between x and x plus delta, then how you can compute. So it is one kind of that you are trying to find the area of the function between x and x plus delta. So here the function is in continuous fashion. Okay, it is varying in continuous fashion. So if you are willing to compute area, so simply a simple concept is coming that you need to integrate the density function from x to x plus delta. That integration is coming. But if you talk about approximation of this integral, then easily you can see that if you talk about this area can be approximated by this area of rectangle. Okay, rectangle. And what is the area of this rectangle? Just you know the height. What is the height of this rectangle? It is f of x. And what is the width? Delta. So easily this integral can be approximated by what quantity? So it is talking about probability that x is observing value between x, actual probability between that x is observing value between x and x plus delta, and this value easily you can approximate it by multiplying the height. Height at x is what? F of x. You can call it here f of x times what is the width? Width is delta. So it is one kind of approximation. That means if you know the probability density function at a point and if you know the width, then you can get approximate value of this integral. And this integral is what? It is talking about probability that x is taking value between x and x plus delta, because x is taking value in continuum fashion. That's why we are coming with this kind of definition of probability. Okay, between x plus delta. So the idea of density might be clear to everyone. So we have to characterize few properties of density. What are those properties? So you can easily see that the density is satisfying certain kind of property. What is that? So because density is going to, it is talking about probability per unit area. So a probability can't be negative. So that means probability always it would be greater than or equal to zero. So due to that, the corresponding density function would be also always greater than or equal to zero. Next, you will see that it is not one kind of property, it is one kind of characterization of continuous random variable. It is talking about what? The continuous random variable is always having a density which happens to be continuous or piecewise continuous. So continuous fashion you will see it here, or piecewise continuous. And this property we are calling a normalizing property. That means if you integrate a continuous density of a continuous random variable from minus infinity to infinity, then the integral would be always equal to 1. This we are calling it normalizing property. It is similar to what summation with respect to probability mass function. We had seen that if we are summing all the probability density mass function with respect to x, then summation happens to be equal to 1. The similar concept summation we have replaced by the integral, and the corresponding probability density function we have replaced by probability mass function we have replaced by probability density function. So that's why this one is talking about normalization property of a probability density function. Okay, further if you talk about this, you can treat as a third property or fourth property also. So what is happening that if x is taking value from a subset of range of random variable x. That means x is what one kind of event simply we are talking about. X is taking value. So b is defining one kind of event. Then we can easily compute probability of b. How we can compute probability of b? By integrating the corresponding density function over b. Here b would be what? It is defined by the continuous random variable x. So b would be either an interval or subinterval or union of intervals. So usually here you are talking about just integral, finding integral of the corresponding density function over that interval or union of interval. Okay, in order to get probability that x is observing value from b. So all these are property of probability density function. Now we will talk about few example. Before going to discuss about few example of continuous random variable, we will discuss about concept of event. How we come up with idea of event in the case of continuous random variable. Okay. So it is very much essential to understand the concept of event because it is different kind of random variable, different than discrete random variable. Okay, and in case of discrete random variable, we had already seen that how we define event in the discrete random variable. Anyone would like to highlight if x is a discrete random variable, then how we define corresponding event or any such kind of event? Anyone? If x is a discrete random variable, then how we define event? Anyone? Are you able to listen to me? Anyone respond? Okay. Then tell me how we define event in case of discrete random variable. We are defining it by that x, the random variable x is observing few value of the random variable. Generally, we define event in, by this kind of situation in case of discrete random variable. Now, here we are having different situation. X is taking value in continuum fashion. That means suppose x is taking value from the interval AB. Okay, this interval AB, it may not be equal to what we call it range of x. It may be just a subset of range of x. So if x is taking value from the interval AB, so this is talking about what? It is saying that x is taking value between A and B. X is taking value between A and B. So this is the event. Okay. Then how we can find probability of this event that X is taking value between A and B? So just what we do, we come up with idea of that probability density function and integrate over B. That means integrate over integrate from A to B. Okay. So this integral will give that probability that X is observing value between A and B, or X is observing value. All possible value of x which is observed in the set B or between A and B. Okay, so this is the way to compute probability of an event. So this is one kind of event. Here you can observe that. So this one is the sample of space. You come up with idea that x is observing value. So here we know that this is set B, and if you try to look in same event x that observing value between A to B, it is having, this is the pre-image outcome way you can observe that that event here in the sampler space is as well. So how you can find the probability that x is observing value between A to B? Either you look for the pre-event pre-image of that x when it is observing value between A to B and compute the probability in the sampler space. That would be a little bit tedious task, but here what you do, here if you come up with idea of density function of x, then easily find the area and get the probability of that event. Okay. Another situation is that if event is that x is observing value between minus infinity to plus infinity, that means it is just x is observing any possible real number. So that means here b equal to r. So for this case, what would be the probability of r? That what is the probability of B? That means when x is observing value between minus infinity to infinity, we know that R set of real number, we can denote it by an interval as well. So interval situation, we can give it like this one. That means any real number if you take, it would be between plus infinity to minus infinity. So So that's where, in order to compute the probability that x is observing value from R, that means we are just going to integrate the probability density function from minus infinity to infinity. And we know that here x is taking all possible value as a real value. So that means it is talking about one kind of exhaustion of all x. And if you see it, what does it talk about? It is just satisfying the normalizing condition. You have taken integral with respect to all x, like for discrete random variable, you, when you take summation of probability density mass function with respect to all x, it is just satisfying normalizing condition. Similar to that, we can see it here as well. If you are integrating a density function for x which is taking value between minus infinity to infinity, then it is just equal to 1. That means it is just satisfying normalizing condition. Okay. Now another situation is coming, that someone is saying that no, let us describe a event by a singleton set. So if it is in singleton set, then automatically you can see that what will if B is in singleton set, that means X is observing a single value, only one value. In that case, how we can compute probability of B? That means here B is what? It is a singleton set. That means if you try to see this in interval fashion, that means it is talking about a closed interval with a terminal point. Both terminal point happens to be the same. So that is the meaning of a singleton point. That means a starting point and end point both are same. That means in order to compute the probability of B, we have to integrate the corresponding density function from A to A itself. And everyone are aware of that. Everyone is aware of that. If you are integrating any function from this from one point to the same point itself, then integral always happens to be equal to zero. That's why probability of a single set that x is observing a single value is always what? Zero. So if x is observing value from the interval, like here, if I'm asking what is the probability of B, single point B, then it would be zero. What is the probability of observing single point A? It would be zero. So that is the concept, that if x is observing any single value, then with probability zero. That means is a very rare kind of situation. Now further we will talk about in a more systematic way. That means if x is a continuous random variable, then we come up with idea of event like that x is observing value less than equal to this x. Okay, x is observing value less than equal to this small x. This one is one kind of event, generally we say that. And if you talk about from the pre-image perspective, that means it is collection of all outcome where the random variable x is having images which are less than equal to x. So it is this you are able to see in the sample space. You are seeing sample space omega, and this event we are defining in the range of continuous random variable. Okay, so it is an event for every x. That means simply we can define the, if you are taking any interval from which x is observing value, that means x is observing value between A to B, then we can always express that event in the framework of this kind of event, this special event. Okay, so how we can define it? So we can say that here x is taking value between A to B. That means it is talking about joint occurrence that x is taking value greater than A and x is taking value less than equal to B. That means this one. So this important notation of event is very much essential. That means in case of continuous random variable, every event can be expressed in terms of this kind of situation. Likewise, if someone is saying that okay, what is the complement of that x is observing value up to A, it is just talking about x is taking value greater than A. So here x is taking value in continuum fashion. So you know from the geometry of a real number, so what situation is, if this point is here, A is here, then this segment we say that A is greater than or equal to A. At this segment we are saying that A is less than equal to A. Equality, you can take it with anyone. Okay, so we can easily see that if x is observing value from this segment, then what is complement of this? Complement of this one is this. Complement, so here these two. So here simply I would like to say that complement of, if you talk about here, complement of the event if you define. Complement of this is just equal to this event. So that situation we will we'll discuss further. Here, just if you talk about atomic level of defining event, then generally we define event by this, and rest of event whatever will come, it will be expressed in term of this. So everything will be generated by this one. So that is the basic concept here. Now, if you say that a random variable x is observing value between a minus 1 by n to a, for every n, remember that focus here on over every n, then this event, it would be equal to what? It would be just, it is talking about for every n, that means we are talking about joint occurrence of all the x which are between the two number for every n. So that means we are just talking about intersection of all event for each n, for every event for each n, so each n. So if you take intersection, easily what will happen? So it will finally, intersection is, that means it will, where it will approach? It will approach to A. Approach to A, and hence if you take intersection of this one, it is just talking about a singleton set, X is observing value equal to A. Okay, so this one is also an event. So it is a legitimate event. So we had already expressed here, if someone is saying that in case of continuous random variable, we can't express this one as an event, that one is not a situation. Here we can express x equal to a as an event. How? Because we are able to express this x equal to a in the framework of this event definition. This is what we atomic level of event concept in case of continuous random variable. So that's why x equal to a, it is a legitimate event. Okay, so that's why we need to calculate the probability of x equal to a, and prior to that we need to calculate probability that x is observing value between a to b. So that concept we had already seen, that means how we compute probability that x is observing value between a to b. So if you can take the notion of the concept from the what we call it joint distribution function as well. So x is observing value between, or simply probability mass function, you can take it that notion. So how you can take it like that? So we know that probability, the f of x, it is talking about what? It is talking about talk from the partition perspective. So x is observing value between a to b, so talk about partition of those value, okay, that interval. Okay, you are partitioning in with member n member, the n member are coming, x naught to x1, x2, x3, likewise it is coming. Okay, so here we know that if you are trying to compute approximate probability that x is observing value between a to x1, so how we can approximate that? That means we multiply the, we here, what is the idea of introducing partition? Partition is helping just to compute probability by approximating this quantity. That means we need to know the value of function here, that probability density function at few points, not like that at every continuum point. It is not like that. Just here we are just finding value of f at x size, and we are multiplying the corresponding width. So here I have taken variable width, you can take it as a constant width. So here it is what? It is talking about probability of that x is observing value from that particular subinterval. Okay, and you sum up, there are n number of subinterval, you sum up all the probability in order to compute overall probability that take value between a, an approximate probability. But here we have taken partition of the interval AB. So you can perform refinement. So you refine, what is meaning of refinement? That means you are increasing the number of partition point. That means keep on increasing as much as possible. So what does it mean? It means that you are taking a limit n tends to infinity. What does it mean? That means if in the process when n is approaching to infinity, all these partition points become very close to each other, and hence we observe the continuum of value of x, continuity will observe. So that's why we are taking limit n tends to infinity of this summation, and it is just what, it is from the definition of integral. What does it talk about? It will converge to integral that f of integral of f of x that when x is taking value from a to b. So it is just definition of integral, what we call it. You had already seen in class 12. So from this same framework, we can compute probability of the event x when it is observing a single value. So we had already expressed that what is meaning of this one. In this case, we will come up with an interval of length 1 by n for every m, and we are just doing further refinement of that interval, and that means we are taking limit n tends to infinity of this probability, approximate probability f of a times 1 by n, and 1 by n is what it is, what if you take limit n tends to infinity where it will converge, it will converge to 0. So that's the probability that x is observing will equal to a, it would be equal to 0. Likewise, here this concept, that means if x is observing value between any subinterval, that it can be approximated by this quantity. This computation is very simple, but if you try to compute this one from the integral, that might be complicated, because here the density function may have a complicated form, but here if you are trying to compute the density function at a point, it is very much simple, because it would be a single real number. So that's why this computation is easy. So it is one kind of this, through this approximation way we can easily compute the probability of x that observing value between a to b. Now I am taking here one example. So wheel of fortune, so everyone might be aware of that wheel of fortune. It is one kind of famous gambling game. Okay, so there is a wheel of fortune. What is happening that in that wheel of fortune, one player is playing that, a gambler is spinning a wheel of fortune continuously. Okay, continuously, and in that case the value is coming between 0 to 1. Okay, value, so it is one kind of random picking of any number between 0 to 1. So that means in the process of spinning a wheel, that there would be one needle, that needle may falls between 0 1 at any point between 0 1 in random fashion. Okay, so that means we are observing the result, what kind of any number between 0 1. If you spin a wheel, then that in that case that needle will fall between between 0 and 1, any number between that situation. So what is happening that, so if you talk about every subinterval of 0 1 of the same length, then that would be equally likely. So here in case of continuous random variable, when we are talking about continuous set, in that case the uniform principle is coming through that every subinterval of length same are treated as equally likely, are equally likely. So that concept, and hence we can say that what is the density function of this here, if you are saying that the random variable x is observing value between 0 and 1 in continuum fashion, then what is the situation, or that, or how we can define density function. So simply we say that if you take it is having equally likely principle, that means this density function is constant throughout 0 and 1, but if you take outside 0 1, there is no observed value, so that way the density function would be 0. So it is coming situation like this way. Here you can, we had defined like x is observing value from this sub interval concept we had come up with. So that means you talk about partition of the interval 0 1, that x is observing value, you can take it equality as well, there is no any issue, it won't affect much. X I plus delta, delta is constant due to equally likely situation. Okay, so here if you you know that here every interval of the same length are equally likely, that means probability of every probability of this one, it is equal to probability that x is observing value pro another interval. Or next interval, or any other interval you can take it. Xi plus 1 plus delta. So equally likely situation is coming. So from here, what is happening that if you try to talk about here, simply if you talk about what situation is coming, this quantity we will talk how we denote, how we approximate this quantity. Anyone would like to highlight how we approximate? We know that this quantity we approximate it by f of value of function at point xi minus 1. Generally always we take left hand side point of the subinterval corresponding minus delta, and this point we this property we denote it by f of x times at point xi time delta, and delta is constant, and we say that equilibrium situation is there. That means x is observing value from any subinterval of length same length having the same probability. That means equilibrium assumption we are putting it. So that's why these two probability are equal to each other. The delta is same, so it will cancel out. What does it talk about? The value of f at xi minus 1 is equal to value of f at xi. Likewise, we can say that if you take any point between zero and one, then corresponding value of density is same. So if suppose you are taking a function for that the value is same everywhere in that domain, then what kind of function that would be? Anyone? If f of x is having value same everywhere in the interval, then that function simply we say that it is taking value constant value. So it is taking a value c between the interval 0, 1. So that's why it is a constant, taking a constant value. So due to uniform principle, we come up with idea that when x is taking value uniformly from the interval 0 to 1, that means the corresponding density would be uniform. How this corresponding density would be constant for that interval, and outside that interval density would be 0. So that's where this definition is coming. And this definition, how it came, that I have already explained it. Okay. Here now, next question would be there that what is C? You need to find C. So one condition you can observe that this density function, you come up with idea of this density function, then this density function have to satisfy all the properties of being a density function. What are those properties? First property that the density function is always greater than or equal to 0. This will say that c is greater than or equal to 0. This simply implies that c is greater than or equal to 0. Okay. Apart from that, f of x, it is definitely continuous function, and hence we can say that it is a continuous piecewise continuous function. Okay. There is no any issues regarding second property. We have to look for third property. What does it talk about? It talk about that if you integrate this one for all x, that x is taking value from minus infinity to infinity of integral of this density function, then it satisfies normalizing condition. That means integral would be equal to 1. So but here what we do, here we don't focus on value of x which is outside interval 0, 1. Why? Because outside 0, 1 this density is 0. We never that if you calibrate that wheel, then it won't take value outside from the interval 0, 1. It will take value always from the interval 0, 1. So this infinite integral, it will be limited to you can break it into three segments: minus infinity to 0, that would be what, 0. Then you can segment it 0 to 1, that one is a legitimate one, and 0 to infinity, again it would be 0. And this summation is equal to 1. And if you integrate this function from 0 to 1, that means integral, you are talking about integral of c times dx, and c is a constant, so it will come out. So you are just integrating dx from 0 to 1, and that integral is equal to 1. And integral of this one is what? Just equal to 1. So from here you will come to see that value of c due to normalizing condition is what? Equal to 1. So this one is your density function, f of x equal to 1. You can delete it here. C you can just So this is your desired density function for this continuous random variable when you are just playing that wheel of fortune. Any question till now? I will just cover one more example. We will generalize this wheel of fortune game, and after that while wind up this class. So we are generalizing this wheel of fortune, that means when x is taking value continuously from the interval 0, 1. Now we are taking another situation, then when x is taking value continuously from the interval AB. AB might be any kind of interval, okay. And here we are putting the uniform principle is that all subinterval of the same length are equally likely. That means we are putting this situation. This situation we are putting. Okay, equally likely situation. Due to that, what we will observe, we will again see that the density function is taking constant value from the interval a to b, and outside the interval a to b, it is taking zero value. So again, here this kind of density function we will observe. Then here question is coming that what is the value of c? So it is very much easily to find value of c. We can easily see that c must be greater than or equal to zero. It must be non-negative. And second, just use normalizing condition, this condition. And from there, we will see that value of c would be equal to 1 by b minus a. That means we can visualize the density function like this way. That means x is observing value between a to b. Outside a to b, x is not observing value. That's where density would be 0 outside a to b. Density, it is having, x is having positive density between a to b only. And what is that? What is the height of that? That density happens to be uniform principle, equally likely situation. So that's where it is having constant density between a to b. What is that constant value? That constant height is 1 by b minus a. This is the constant height. Value of c is equal to 1 by b minus a. So this kind of random continuous random variable, we are calling it uniform continuous random variable. Simply you can say that uniform random variable. It is taking value uniformly between the interval a to b. Uniformly, through it is taking value through uniform principle. Okay, this is the uniform principle in case of continuous random variable. So other thing we will discuss in next class regarding attendance, just